After 4 months of daily practice and 10 regular season games, it all came down to 60 minutes for the Penn football team. Saturday, the 13th-ranked Statesmen hosted the number 9 Grand View Vikings for a chance to advance to the playoffs for just the second time in school history. So with everything on the line for both teams, who will be playing this weekend for a chance to move closer to the national championships? CRI and OSP's Jason Madison has the recap.
William Penn and Grandview at it again, as a season, a playoff bid, and the Rock and Ladder Trophy were up for grabs. It's been a while since the trophy was in Oskaloosa, 2010 to be exact, after a 38-7 homecoming win. However, this time around, the Vikings strolled into Lacey Stadium with the hardware and the expectations of keeping it. Before kickoff, things were a bit emotional on senior day for parents, players, and for head coach Todd Hafner.
Today is a day of pride. Today is a day of commitment to your teammates. Today is a day to lay it all on the line for the cause. I love every one of you. And I know that you're going to give it all for each other today.
In the first quarter, the Statesmen enter the Vikings' red zone after junior quarterback Taylor Parsons finds a hole near side and breaks off the 17-yard run. But after the play, things got a bit chippy when Grandview was called for unnecessary roughness and penalized 9 yards, moving the ball to the 11-yard line. One play later, and it's Parsons again, faking out Grandview and the cameraman as he crosses the plane for the first score of the game. Penn up 7-0 and ends the first quarter. Moving to the second, and Penn is up 10-0 after a Marcus Kerrigan 28-yard field goal. And Penn is on the move, but without starting quarterback Taylor Parsons, who left the game with concussion-like symptoms. So whose number would be called? Lucky number 7, senior running back Joel Medina, who takes the pitch, gets a nice block from wideout Ed Cazenet, and jets up the sideline for 27 yards. Three plays later, with 2 minutes left before halftime, backup quarterback Tyler Hafner hands off to Medina, and he gets some nice blocks up front and scores WPU's second touchdown of the game, Penn up 17-0. But with 10 seconds on the clock, Grandview puts a scare on the home team when quarterback Derek Bolton hooks up with Darius White. White gets the first step on 3 Statesmen before senior safety Joseph Fry ends the 35-yard scamper without a score. Now in the second half, the Statesmen D continue to dominate with hits like this, keeping the Vikings off the scoreboard. Ending the third quarter, Penn's front four were relentless, not giving Fulton time to pass or time to even scramble. But in the fourth, Grandview found its groove. With 10 minutes to go on Penn's 27-yard line, Fulton airs it out to Brady Rollins for 25 yards before he stopped at the 2-yard line, shy of the touchdown. Grandview would punch it in on the next play, but failed to get the 2-point conversion, and the score is 17-6 for the moment. On the following drive, the minute 20 to work, Fulton connects with White before Penn's Michael Wright lays the hammer. White holds on to the ball, and the Vikings would drive all the way down to Penn's 2-yard line. With only 8 ticks left, Fulton hits White in the back of the end zone, and Grandview edges closer. But another 2-point conversion fails as the trickery doesn't work, and Penn caps off the regular season with a win, a share of the Midwest League Conference Championship, and oh yeah, the Rock and Ladder Trophy.
I thought our kids were unbelievable today. They played with so much heart and enthusiasm and care about each other, and it's just one of those things that you can't describe. You can't describe the feeling of winning a championship and having an opportunity to continue on, and to beat a great team like Grandview makes it all that much more special.
William Penn escaped despite being outgained 450 yards to his 331. 324 of those yards came on the ground. A week after struggling to get pressure on St. Ambrose, the Statesmen defense sacked the Vikings quarterback Derek Fulton 5 times, including 2 by sophomore defensive end Nick DeMarco. Junior defensive back Jacob Batterson highlighted the group with 12 tackles and 2 pass breakups.
Wow, that's freaking awesome! Yeah!
For the first time in 37 years, Penn is back in the playoff picture. After the game, defensive tackle and team captain Michael Welch expressed his team's desire to push the program to this point.
From coming in as a freshman to 6:30 workouts to seeing seniors leave before me, not having this opportunity, man, I just put it upon myself to lead these guys to opportunity to get into the playoffs. And I mean, these guys wanted it. This is the hungriest team I ever been on, man. These guys wanted it, and our coaching staff wanted it. I mean, we came together as a family and just got it done.
The 13th-ranked Statesmen travel to Chicago, Illinois this Saturday to face number 4 St. Xavier in the first round of the NAIA Football Championship Series. Kickoff is at noon at Bruce R. Deaton Memorial Field. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Jason Madison.